Are you tired of your 9-to-5 job? You honestly feel like there's no sense of purpose, like there's no purpose in life. You honestly tried everything. You tried drinking coffee, you tried going out on a run in the morning, in the evening, you probably also tried yoga. Then, here's a good news for you. Miracle Mentality, every morning, a devotion just made for you with Pastor Jolly George so that you can have some sense of purpose in life. Just like
praise the Lord and good morning. We want to wish you a very happy birthday, all those who are celebrating your birthdays today, along with Psalm 139 verse 14. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, my soul knows it very well. And all those who are celebrating your wedding anniversaries, we like to wish you a very happy wedding anniversary to you today, along with Colossians chapter 3 verse 14. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Have a blessed day. Let us read 1 Samuel chapter 9 verses 19 to 21. I am the seer, Samuel replied. Go up ahead of me to the high place, for today you are to eat with me, and in the morning I will send you on your way and will tell you all that is in your heart. As for the donkeys you lost 3 days ago, do not worry about them, they have been found. And to whom is all the desires of Israel turned, if not you and your whole family line? Saul answered, but I am not a Benjaminite from the smallest tribe of Israel, and is not my clan the least of all the clans of the tribe of Benjamin? Why do you say such a thing to me? Now Saul and his servant decided to go and see a seer. For what? To find out about their donkeys. They know that the prophet Samuel, there's a prophet, his name is Samuel, and he is able to help them to find their donkeys. So according to the plan, they had taken something, quarter shekel of money they have taken, and they went to prophet Samuel. So they were asking about the seer, they were inquiring about the seer. Then prophet Samuel introduced himself and saying that I am the seer. But the strange things happened. Before Saul reaches there, God informed him that he is going to be the king of Israel, anoint him. The Saul was in search of his little problem, but God has found a solution in Saul for his people, for his kingdom, for his home called Israel. Hallelujah. God was orchestrating everything. But when Prophet Samuel was talking about his rule, or he's the one who selected to rule the Israel, Saul's response was, I am not a great person. I am not even a Benjaminite from the smallest tribe of Israel, and my clan is the least clan. How it can be happen? Why do you say such things to me? But we know that one thing, your background doesn't matter. If God chooses you, God elects you, He calls you, it's not your background, it's not your qualification, it's not your merit, it doesn't matter from where you have come from. It's all matters is His selection, His call in your life, because He is the one who calls and qualifies it. He is the one who calls and equips it. And not only that, God is not the respecter of any person. God saw in Saul, or God saw Saul as an answer to the issues which the people of Israel facing. And also one thing we need to understand, that where you are going is better place than where you have come from. Because God has seen you. Or God has seen something great in you. He has seen you as a changing agent. He has seen you as a world shaker. Therefore, He has selected you, because the promotion doesn't come from the south or the west or from the east, not from anywhere, but the promotion comes from the Lord. He is the promoter. Saul did not have anybody to promote him, because that selection of the king or the kingship was not known in Israel. That God selected Saul. there was nobody to put a campaign for him, nobody to promote him, nobody to support him, nobody to do anything for him. But there was a supernatural selection in his life. There was a supernatural election in his life. So that was called God's election. Hallelujah. So whoever you are, from where you are, come from, what was your background, it doesn't matter, because you are chosen and you are handpicked by the Lord for his work. That's what the Bible says. He uses the weak things of the world to confound the wise. Hallelujah. So it doesn't matter who you are, whether you are educated or uneducated, whether you are qualified or not qualified. God has handpicked you and he calls you and qualifies you. Hallelujah. So trust in him, trust in his call, respond to his call. Whoever you are, he is calling you today for his work. Hallelujah. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you and we praise you for this beautiful morning. Thank you for your election. Thank you, Lord, you have called us. We are the chosen generation, royal priesthood, Lord. A special people, Father God. A holy nation, Lord. We thank you for your election in our lives. Thank you for making us as kings and priests, Lord. Thank you for bringing us as a solution, as a changing agent. Thank you for picking us, Father, for the work of your kingdom, Lord. We thank you and we praise you. Lord, also I pray for all those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries and their birthdays. Bless them, Lord. Thank you for selecting them. Thank you for choosing them too, Lord. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Have a blessed day.